welcome to my channel. Today we are going to make a custom drop down that you can use in a form or any of other places in PowerApps. So the drop down option that we have, which is somewhere over here, so this feature might not be good enough for lots of cases when you have a customized drop down. So this drop down just gives you one option, but maybe you need a drop down which gives you multiple values underneath this main value. So in that cases you might not use this drop down and might be able to create some other drop downs that we have. So for that, what we can do is we can use a text input. So this acts as a search for the drop down. So we can just put search the value. So once it's done, you can add a gallery here. So this is the gallery that acts as dropdown. I'll change the layout to something like this. Or just have a two value dropdown. So let's add a border here, some border to give it an authentic look of a dropdown. Since the font is small, I can just reduce the font to whatever it has. So it has 13, so I'll just keep this as 13, this as something like 11. I can connect it to a data source, so I'll just use the count. So I'll put, I think email is available, so I'll put emails. So we have a drop down that has emails and everything. You can change the design as you look want, but this is something that how it looks. Now to give it the feel of drop down, I need to put a down icon over here. So here I can put a down icon. And just so that this filters on the basis of whatever value that we put here, we'll put. So I am putting a search function here, so that based on the search here, if you see the syntax of the search, you need to put the source, which is counts. Then we need to find the text. So text would be the name of this text box, which is text input 1. So whatever value that we put in text input 1 dot text, and we need to search in a column, and the column will be count. So count name, I can just type name, I think. So based on whatever we type here, it will show up in this text. So let's fill it out. And I think I made a mistake. So let's put the value as search the value here and not here. So when there's nothing, it gives you all the value, but when you search for something, it will give you the value whatever you search here. But I don't want this to appear all the time, so I'll put visible as, so drop down and this text. And since we need to initialize the value of so drop down on the start of the app, so I will put the context, or you can just use set here as well, false. So I'll run on start, it's false right now, and when you click this it'll show and hide. But you might want to show when you click here as well. So on click or on change, same as this. What we can do is on change if self dot text so I'm checking if the value that our text input is blank or not. If it is, then put sub show dropdown as false. If it's not, then I will put this as I think the better way to code this would be, I'll just copy this here, put it here, and it's blank. So if it is blank, so dropdown will be false. If it is true, so dropdown will be true as well. Some syntax fixing. I guess it should work now. So I'm changing it. So I need to. Be fine, I guess. Yeah. So now, if there is no value, then it will hide. It will show Microsoft. So in this way, you can create the dropdown that you can put. You can also put this in the form. You can replace this dropdown with this, and on the update property of the form, you can put the value what you get selected from this gallery. So in this way we can create custom dropdown in PowerApps. If you like my video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get notified for all the updates. Thank you very much.